Good afternoon. Steel Horse around. Remember, subscribe to my channel, like my videos. I have views, but I need subscribers, so help me grow my channel. Well, it's March, and springtime has sprung. The trees are turning green, the buds are out, and the blooms are out on some of those trees. And it's like 88 degrees today. I think spring has arrived in North Texas. My flag arrived. I was going to do stickers and maybe poker chips, and I'm still probably going to do the sticker trade with everybody for the Motovloggers. But I came across this. I was messing with my logo, and something dawned on me. Hey, I can make a custom flag pretty cheap. And I got it off of Amazon. Been busy. My dad passed away a few weeks ago, so there are a lot of changes. Y'all, you remember the old song? Maybe the birds. To everything there's a season. Turn. There is a time. A time to be born. A time to die. A time to live, laugh. A time to cry. To everything under heaven there is a season. We're in the spring season. The trees are blooming. And life changes are happening. Lost my dad. Lost my mom 3 years ago. Almost the same time of year. Spring. The time of metaphorically new life and new birth and trees blooming and the flowers and the birds and all that stuff. Here lately in the last 3 years has not been that for me. So there are changes. Saw the news about Harley CEO Levatich stepping down. Hope it doesn't go the way of my victory made by Polaris. They gave up on victory. They had loyal customers, people loved them. This is a V92, and I started, you know, doing the whole immersing myself in the whole motorcycle culture, and found out that people were very loyal to Victory, and they loved Victory, and they were not happy when they went under. And it could be the same thing with Harley. I mean, you never know. You would think they wouldn't fail, but you never know. This Victory, I looked a while ago, I googled it. When it was new, it's a 2003, and I think the price point on it was like $13,000-$14,000. And this is the big cruiser. It didn't have a lot of bells and whistles, a lot of new technology and GPS and stereo and all that stuff. Just a basic stripped down big old V-twin cruiser. That's my deal. I bought this cheap. I got it for under $5,000. And now you can buy them anywhere from, you know, $1,700 up to $3,000 or $4,000, depending on the condition and mileage. All some of them retaining their breath. There's a lot of debate in the Victory community. Will they hold their value? Will they go up in price? Will they go down? What happens to them? And, you know, will it be a collector's thing? They might. You know, it's like an old Indian or something from way back in the 40s or 30s. They're worth a lot of money. Will these Victories be that? I don't know. And I bought the Ninja for my son to ride. He ended up not wanting to ride, really, so I ride it, and it's fun. Nice little sport bike, you know, metric imports, and it's lightweight. It's like riding a bicycle. Price point. I mean, I had a truck that I drove for 17 years, drove the wheels off of it, finally traded it in. It was still running at the start, just had some issues. Traded it in on the SUV and thought, well, I can pull a trailer, you know, if I need to. $6,000, $8,000. I mean, for people like me, it's not a question of, I can hear people, it's a lifestyle. It's all about this and the leather vest and all. I get that. I'm in my 50s and I just want to have fun. I like the idea. I like the leather coat and the jeans and whatever. It's fun to go be cool and go somewhere and go grab something to eat. As you can see, my garage is still a wreck. Sorry. Anyhow, back to the motorcycles. I need to go ride. I need to make a vlog. I need to check out my, worked on my microphone. I have a lot of noise going on in there when I ride, or popping noise and something bothering me about it. I hadn't had time to do that. And the weather now is supposed to rain 2-3 days, and got a dumpster sitting in my dad's driveway. I gotta get a lot of stuff out of the house, just a lot of junk stuff out of the garage. It's just useless. That's always fun. So changes, season of change, they will come. And as the verse says, this too shall pass. And as long as you wake up every day and your heart's still beating, it will pass, and you will go through things whether you want to go through them or not. That seems to be how that goes. Harley, I hope they make it. Victory didn't really fail. Polaris just decided to put their money into the Indian brand, which, you know, logically makes sense, I guess, you know. What do you do? I think the young guys all need sport bikes and stuff, and they're fun. I like both. I like both. $30,000 for something that I do for fun in my middle life. I would really put money into an IRA, money into my mortgage into my house where I know that's a solid investment. This is fun for me, and I can afford. So how many of these for $30,000? At $5,000 a piece, I could buy 6 motorcycles, run the wheels off of them, not worry about, you know, at the $30,000, it wouldn't matter, you know, how much I paid. I would get my money's worth, and I'd be having fun for a lot cheaper price. And I know it's a premium brand, and I know it's like buying a Cadillac or a Mercedes or something. I understand. I've had friends that bought them. I had a friend bought the big $30,000 anniversary edition, bronze and black. It was really beautiful, and he loved it and was all into that. And they bought the Harley gear, the shirts, the vest, the jackets. Rode with friends. A few years later, he was done with it. Price point, I don't know what happened. He sold the motorcycle. He did not buy another one. That's the deal. And he's not 60. He's just now maybe 50. He's about my age. So he didn't, it's not like he's too old. He just went back into the four-wheelers. He gets out and plays in the mud with that. And he was always into Jeeps. And he went back to those hobbies. And I don't know if it's because of the price point. I don't know. I just know he didn't buy another Harley. So that seems to be an issue for Harley. It's people not really buying them. And I don't know. Who knows? Too big to fail, like the banks? I don't know. We know changes will happen. Either way, like my channel. We'll do some more fun videos, but like my channel. Hit the bell so you know you get notifications when I put up new videos. And steel horse around. We're going to ride the motorcycle. Thanks for watching.